Welcome back to The Goal-Getter Life. I'm Cindy Knorr, and in this video, I'm going to tell you all about a visualization technique that hardly anybody is using, and it is so life-changing and amazing that you are going to love it. So you've heard about the movie The Secret. It came out in 2006.
This is the great secret of life.
Right after that movie was released, a lot of people got all excited about the law of attraction and they got all fired up about it. And gradually over the years, they got pretty disillusioned because they tried it and it didn't really work for them. And there's a reason that it didn't work. And that's because there's a secret that the movie The Secret didn't tell us about enough. Like it sort of hinted on some of these things, but it didn't clarify it clearly enough for everybody. So if you're someone who keeps a vision board, or maybe you're someone who writes your goals out and you review them regularly, and that's what I highly recommend that you do, because that is the most powerful thing for you to start achieving your goals. But even if you don't do those things, but you have an idea of what you want to accomplish in the future, and you keep that idea in your mind, this technique that I'm going to tell you about today is going to be so powerful, and you'll see how it worked for me. So just to give you an idea, here's a video of me when I weighed 220 pounds. At that time, I was working hard in my photography business and my kids were little and I was really busy. And I kept saying that I didn't have time to exercise. And that's what a lot of people say. They use that excuse. I don't have time to exercise. And I'm sure you've heard that before, and maybe you've heard it come from your own lips before, but I got to a point where I started to feel so miserable with myself and with my health that I couldn't take it anymore. And I made up my mind that I was going to do something about it. And so I decided to just start walking. I decided to just take the smallest of actions and just start doing it every day. And the other thing that I decided to do was to make a green smoothie, which is just whipped up vegetables, whatever I could find, and add that to whatever I was eating in the day. So just try to eat a little healthier and get a little bit of movement every day. So just those two little things, that's what made the biggest difference in my life. Most people actually try to do too much and that never works. The trick is to make it a habit so that it's easier for you, and then you don't have to think about it, because habits actually run our lives for us. So besides developing the habit, the big secret that the Big Secret movie didn't tell us all about, there's something that is so amazing in visualization. So The Secret touched on that, but they didn't get into it clear enough, because that's why so many people are getting disillusioned with the whole idea. Athletes have been using this since the 1960s, and they call it mental rehearsal. And the top athletes will envision themselves doing whatever is necessary for them to succeed. And if you think about an Olympic athlete or a peak performer, sometimes when it's in a race, success to them is a matter of seconds or milliseconds. So if visualization and mental rehearsal works for people like these top athletes, then it for sure will work for people like us whose margins are not that tight. Like, it doesn't matter, our goals are not within seconds or milliseconds. So I told you about how I used to weigh 220 pounds. I used to go on all kinds of diets. I would lose weight and then I'd gain it all back again. And this time, it is completely different. I can guarantee you I am never going to go back up there again. I can tell you that with confidence, and here's why. Once I decided to make my health my number one priority and to make time during my day for it and not use the excuse anymore that I didn't have time for it, and I decided to go for walks, I would go outside for walks as much as I could, which is the best because it's great for us to get some vitamin D from the sun and just to be in nature. But where I live, it gets pretty cold in the winter, so a lot of us have treadmills. And most people use their treadmill for hanging clothes on it and stuff like that, but I actually started to use mine. So while walking on my treadmill, I would envision my ideal future self, who was happy and healthy and so vibrant. I would envision myself walking towards me and cheering me on. And I know this might sound a little corny, and it might even sound too woo-woo for you, but trust me, it works. And you can just look at me and see for yourself. So research has shown that our brains can't tell the difference between something that's real or imagined. And you know that because if you're watching a fantasy movie or a really scary movie, and even though you know it's not real and it's not possible in your life, you can't stop your heart from racing and your hair from going up on the back of your neck. And even if you go to the washroom, you come out of there and you're looking around wondering what's around the corner. So your brain can't tell the difference between what's real or imagined. And it also can't tell the difference between something that you're thinking about in the past or the future or compared to the present. So you know that because if you think about something traumatic that happened to you in the past, you can get yourself back into that same feeling state that you had back then. And it doesn't even have to be about you. You can be hearing a story about a friend of yours, someone who's really close to you, something that they're going through or something that happened to one of their kids, and you can feel that. So your brain, it can't tell. So we can use this to our advantage. When we think about visualization, we can think about something really clearly that we want for ourselves in the future. Think of ourselves being successful. This opens up all of the creative pathways inside your brain. And once your brain sees that you are successful, it doesn't know, like I said, whether this is past, present, future, real or unreal, it doesn't care. It sees you believing that you are successful. And so when you go about your day, different opportunities will open up for you. Things that you will notice, they seem like things are just falling into place for you. That's because your brain is noticing these things because it feels like you're already successful and that's what you should have in your life. So what happens is you program your brain to be more receptive to what's in your immediate surroundings that will lead to your success. And more importantly, it activates your internal motivation so that you take the steps that are necessary to lead you to that success. So here's how it worked for me. I would be walking on the treadmill. I'm gonna get this baby fired up. And I don't have any footage of when I was 220 pounds walking on the treadmill. So here's a picture of me when I was 220 pounds. You just have to imagine this same version of me. Imagine me standing up and on the treadmill. I think I'm not gonna go as fast as I usually go on here because otherwise I won't be able to talk to you. So I'd be walking on the treadmill and I would imagine that this right in front of me here is a beautiful garden. And over there by where my bookcase is, I would see my future self, this beautiful woman, come walking out from around that corner in this garden and come walking right towards me. And she'd be dressed so beautifully and she'd be so happy and she looks so fit and amazing. And I'm gonna pause this and tell you about the next part, because she'd come right up to me and she'd say, "I'm you. You're right where you need to be right now. Just keep going. I'm you." And literally, I got goosebumps when I think about that right now, even though that was so long ago when I used to do this visualization, because she would just come and cheer me on. And then she came closer to me, and I remember hugging her, and I would feel the sides of her body, and she would kind of giggle because I know she was thinking how awkward it must seem that I'm feeling sides of her body. But she'd say, "Don't worry, it's your body. You can feel it, it's okay." And it felt really amazing. And then before she left, she would just say to me one more time, "Just keep going, you're doing it. And I am you." And I knew that was my future self that was coming to talk to me. So she'd turn around and back down the garden path, she'd go back to around the corner there, around disappear behind the bookcase. So I did this visualization many times. And each time I did it, as I kept walking and as I kept having my green smoothie and trying to eat better, and I was losing a little bit of weight and starting to feel better, and every time she came, it would be like she'd be like, "Whoa, look at you, girl." Like, she'd be so excited because you could see the difference in my body. I was starting to look better and feel better. And she would still, she just, every time I imagined her coming and cheering me on, and she'd be the same thing. She'd say, "I'm you. Keep going. And in no time, you are going to be me, because I am you," right? So that is my amazing example of how you can use visualization to achieve whatever it is that you want in your life. Get your future self to come and talk to you and to cheer you on. Okay, you'll notice that I didn't say that you can sit on the sofa eating junk food and visualize your awesome future with great detail and your success, because that is not going to work, right? You actually have to take action. And I was actually taking action while I was visualizing. Sometimes you're not going to be able to do it at the same time, but taking action is the important step. And the thing that I want you to keep in mind is that we tend to overestimate what we can accomplish in a short period of time. So for example, when we think about weight loss or getting in shape, we often try to lose weight before a reunion or a wedding or a vacation where you got to wear a swimsuit. And that never works out very well. When you try to lose it fast, you're not going to keep it off. So we tend to overestimate how much we can accomplish in a short period of time, and we underestimate how much we can accomplish in a long period of time. So for myself, just walking a little bit every day and trying to eat a little healthier, I would lose about 5 pounds a month. And when you think about that, over a year, that's 60 pounds. And even if you just lost 2 pounds a month, 24 pounds is amazing if that's what you want to do with your life. So I just want you to realize that you can make healthy habits, and if you stretch it out and you just try to do something awesome for yourself every day, over the long term, it adds up. It adds up to a lot, a huge benefit to you. And so that's how I know that those habits that I developed over the year are something that I'm going to be able to maintain. It's a healthy lifestyle that I've established, and that's how I know that I am never going back there again. And if there are some times when I might slack off or kind of fall off the wagon a little bit, I have this powerful visualization technique that I can call on my future self to come back and cheer me on again, or kick my butt, or whatever it is that I need to get moving, right? So I'm wondering, what is it that you want to accomplish in your life? Because you can use this visualization technique for anything. You can use it to find your ideal partner. You can use it to lose weight or to get fit or to get a new job or a raise or get new clients. You can use it for whatever it is that you want. And the trick is to first believe that it's possible for you, then really see it in your mind, in your visualization, and feel it. If you can add as much emotion as you can, like I had in my example, how I was so happy and I got goosebumps even thinking about it, and she giggled, and like whatever, anything that you can make it feel realer, that's a real word. Anything that you can make it feel more real, and just ramp up the emotion and then actually take action. There's a saying, which I'm sure you've heard before, it's, I'll believe it when I see it. But they actually have that backwards, because when you believe it, that's when you're going to see it in your life. I'd love to know how you use visualizations to accomplish goals in your life. And if you haven't used visualizations yet, maybe let us know where you would consider using them, and let us know how it goes. Leave your comments below, because this is such an important and interesting topic that we can all learn from and inspire each other. Thank you for watching this video. For more everyday strategies on how to be your best and how to live an awesome life, subscribe to this channel. Hit the bell so you can be notified when other videos are released. And comment, like, and share this video with other people. Until next time, I'm Cindy Knorr, certified high performance coach and change agent with Synergy Coaching. The best in me recognizes and honors the very best in you.